So I have a new book out, which is called Decoding Air Travel. And we're having the premiere tonight. But the reason I wrote it was that in the past 10 years, I've been traveling around the world as a correspondent, first for the Financial Times and then the Washington Times. And I learned the ins and outs of air travel. And the two major aspects of that, of course, are money and hassle or comfort. So I decided when I first went to the Washington Times that I wanted to travel more to cover the world, and I only have a very limited budget. So I learned everything there is to learn about airfares. And within a year, with the budget that my predecessor was doing, only 3 to 4 trips a year, I was able to do about 10. My other issue was that I didn't want to fly in coach, so I had to figure out a way to pay for coach but never sit in that cabin. So I learned everything about frequent flyer programs, elite status, upgrades, awards and all that. And in the past 9 years, I've had a 100% success rate with upgrades. So the point is, if we, as most of us are unhappy with the airline system today, with the air travel system, it's become very complex. It's become very frustrating. And there's little we as consumers can do to change that. But there is a lot we can do to learn about the system and make it work better for us, meaning so we can pay less money, we can have more comfort and even luxury at lower prices. And that's what I did. I learned what is basically the science of air travel, with everything about airfares, even the codes, their letters, their codes, their numbers that you have to learn. And once I did that, I was able to actually beat the prices that the airlines were giving me for various tickets. And then I started thinking strategically about upgrades, maximizing miles, using miles for the best award ticket so I can go to places in the world where I wanted to go, not where the airlines wanted me to go. And it's worked out, I thought, pretty well, so I decided to help other people who are frustrated. People who tell me that they don't want to travel anymore because it's a nightmare. And my point is, no, if you really know what you're doing, travel can be much less expensive, can be actually exciting and fun, and it should be exciting and fun. And that's what I've tried to do with combining all these pieces with the fares, how much money we pay, the upgrades, the comfort, the luxury, and how to avoid the hassle during the trips at the airport and in other places, and also how to take care and handle things that happen that are beyond our control. Natural disasters, political violence, wars, volcanoes. What do we do if we are supposed to fly somewhere and suddenly the volcano erupts, or there's a protest in a country like there is in Greece at the moment? What do we do? Who do we call? Do we go to the airport and try to rebook? Do we call someone from home? What do we do? So in my book, there are specific suggestions, recommendations, and strategies of what to do to learn how to predict delays and cancellations and how to handle all these disruptions that are mostly beyond human control.